In this video, I'll demonstrate the Android emulator capabilities of Kasm Workspaces. With Kasm, you can seamlessly launch Redroid, a powerful multi-architecture GPU-enabled Android in the cloud solution. This allows you to access an Android emulator directly from your web browser. I will also show you how to automate installing APK files on your emulator as soon as your session starts, so you don't have to manually do it every time. To install Redroid, navigate to your Kasm admin panel and then go to Workspaces, Registry. Install the Redroid image from the list of available images in the Kasm registry. Once the Redroid workspace is downloaded, you can launch it. But this workspace may not work out of the box because you need to install some host dependencies to be able to support Redroid. This is documented on our GitHub. Simply copy and paste these commands to install the binder Linux kernel modules on your host. Once installed, you can try launching Redroid again, and this time you won't see any issues. Every time the session starts, the Redroid Docker image is automatically pulled inside the session container. This is made possible with Docker-in-Docker technology that Kasm supports. Once the image is pulled, it automatically launches the Android emulator window. You can also see this workspace comes with Android Studio and VS Code pre-installed for development purposes. To install an APK on your emulator, you first need to upload the APK file. Go to your control panel and then select Upload. Choose the APK file you want to upload to your Kasm session. You can now open a new terminal in your session and go to the Uploads directory in your home folder to verify whether the APK file has been uploaded. You can now install the APK file using the Android debug bridge. First, list all the available devices by running adb space devices. To install the APK file, run adb space -s followed by the device space install and then the path to your APK file. This will install the APK on your emulator and you can now use the installed app. Do note that you can also configure the streaming quality of your workspace session from your control panel. The higher the streaming quality, the more resources Kasm consumes. Instead of having to manually install the required APKs, you can automate it with volume mappings and Docker exec config override. Simply create a new folder on your host for the Kasm volume mapping, and then give it the appropriate permissions. Now move all the APKs you want to install into this folder. Go back to the Kasm admin panel and then go to Workspaces. Edit your Redroid image and scroll down until you see volume mappings. Paste the volume mapping config here. This config mounts the Kasm user share directory that I just created from the host to the share directory inside the session. I will also configure the Docker exec config override in order to automatically install the mounted APK files. This config first waits for the Redroid image to download, and then waits for the ADB device to come online. Once the device is online, it then installs the APK file with ADB. You can install multiple APKs in the same way. Save the settings and now launch the Redroid workspace again. Once the Redroid image is pulled and the ADB device comes online, the APK will be automatically installed and it will be ready to use when the Android emulator window shows up. You can also configure different settings for this image by modifying its environment variables. For example, you can set the maximum FPS of your emulator, its width and height, and also choose the version of Android you want to run. For example, if I want to run Android version 14, I will simply go back to my workspace settings, scroll down to Docker run config override, and replace the Android version from 13.0.0 to 14.0.0. And when I now launch the workspace, you can see that the Android version inside the emulator has changed to 14.